And welcome to another session of Sunday Setups. Today we're going to be going through the market outlook. First and foremost, if you haven't already, be sure to check out lakecapital.co.uk. We have a lot of information on here for beginners that can help you understand the market. If you are already a trader who would like to take your trading to the next level, then it's highly advisable that you guys check out our courses, see what we can provide, and also secure the bag. Check our merchandise out on Lit Capital's Lit store. And be sure, guys, if you haven't already, to jump into the Discord and liberate yourself from this lockdown nonsense and get yourself another stream of income. We're going to start by looking at the DXY. We've got a few people inside the call. How are you doing? Hope you're well. Tuesday is when we really get some type of movement. So if you guys don't already know, you should know, Monday is usually the day where we sit on the sidelines, wait for some liquidity to enter the market and really start to use the data to our advantage to see what the markets are looking like. So on Tuesday, we've got a budget release, a CPI for China, which isn't really going to affect us much. The US has a CPI release, which can cause some disturbance within the market. But Wednesday, more interestingly, we go into the interest rate for the New Zealand dollar, along with some GDP news for the pound. So we've got a really, really interesting week ahead. Thursday gives us the unemployment that we're going to look out for, combined on Friday with some more GDP in the euro. So we've got a good week, enough data to kind of form a census of what we're looking for and exactly what we're going to be doing on the charts. So with that being said, I'm going to start off by looking at the DXY. Now, interestingly enough, with the DXY, we had this push down towards the end of the week. We really was looking for a push down throughout the whole week. We got the pullback, which is always anticipated after a rally down. But if we check the bond market, we'll also see the bond market is trading a lot lower as well. So interestingly, what we're going to see just from tomorrow or today, tonight's open combined with tomorrow's, how the markets look to pan out. Of course, we've got that news on Tuesday with the pound. With the dollar. So we really want to see what can happen. I'm anticipating these equal lows to be taken out beneath here. If we have a look from the weekly time frame. You lot hear me? Hello? Yeah, you lot should be able to hear me. Yeah, okay, cool. So from that being said, what we're looking at from the weekly time frame, it does look very choppy. So it's not something that we can really ascertain the direction from, but we understand the order flow is bullish. Okay, which means there's a lot of buyers that's been, buying since 2018. So there's a lot of downside potential. Of course, looking out at the bigger picture, we can see there's equal highs above. And if we go up to the monthly time frame, we'll see something similar, which is there's buyers to the upside, sellers to the upside. But, you know, when we're looking at the bigger picture, we understand the dollar has to lose its strength sometime soon. With that being said, we've got a lot of things going on fundamentally. That's going to be certain drives within certain economies. Like, for example, with the lockdown, how soon economies are looking to get back up and running is going to really give a good clue on which economy is going to perform stronger. So just from looking at the daily, there's equal highs above. We want it to push lower, but in order for it to push lower, the market needs to come up and grab some liquidity first. So don't be surprised if we do see the dollar come back across 100 and really take these highs before continuing lower. Moving on to AUD/USD. I gave out this trade on Friday as a setup within our charts channel in the Discord. If you're not already in there, be sure to click the link at the bottom of this video. But what we're looking to see really is providing the dollar. If I just go back to the dollar, providing the dollar can come higher, okay, can come to these levels, to take out these highs, this is really going to push down all the majors. So GU, AU, and EU are really going to look to come down a lot lower. The move we're looking for isn't, you know, it's not a colossal move. It's only 135 pips, so it's not something we're really looking at to say, okay, we're going to hold this for quite an amount of time. As you can see, we've had some really nice trades to the upside. So we can see that from the upside. Sorry, guys, we've been able to hold this for quite some time. Again, this trade was given out within the charts channel, so we're now looking at hedging some of our trades against a potential short. But you know, from looking at the higher time frames, I can just the high time frame does still show you that price has every reason to keep pushing higher. Okay, if price continues to push higher, I will be looking at price coming to take out these highs up here. So I'm anticipating the pullback right now. We're riding a short wave down. You know, I'll be happy with 100 pips. But again, we'll keep you guys updated in the Discord. Euro NZD, a really nice pair that we looked at last week. I gave some of these, I gave a trade out to one of the students. I'll say no names because I didn't put it in the charts channel. But interestingly enough, what we've seen is a nice bearish move to the downside. So all that's telling you guys is throughout this bearish move we've had, let's go over to the weekly. Okay, last week's Sunday setup call, I told you we're still looking bearish. We had a major move to the downside over 300 pips within this candle. Now we can anticipate a pullback. Okay, we can anticipate a pullback back into this area, maybe for price to consolidate. The euro seems to be going into a lot. The euro seems to be going into a more positive space in terms of trying to get their economy back up and running. That doesn't necessarily mean it's going to work, but it just means they're the first to do it. That's, you know, around the EU and UK. So we may just see prices push right back up into this area by going to a 4 hour. We should be able to see prices come back up, challenge these this lower high. Click, grab some liquidity before continuation downwards. Of course, we have the interest rate for NZD this week. So that means, you know, potentially based on the outcome, if the interest rate remains the same, then it should be a negative outlook. And if it's a negative outlook, then we should see Euro NZD push right back up. So we're going to keep you guys updated with this one and let you know how it goes as time goes on. Euro AUD. Another pair, it works just as well. If you guys don't trade Euro AUD, but you trade GA, which is GBP AUD, then have a look at the similarities. If you can find a setup on GA, you'll most likely be able to find a setup on EA. With that being said, again, the Euro's got news coming out this week, excuse me, that's really going to give us an understanding on where this is going. Aussie follows the Kiwi. So if we get a weaker interest rate for the Kiwi, we can expect to see some bullishness within the market here. Look, we've had a very, let's go over to the weekly. Just like Euro NZD, okay, we've had a bearish week. Now we're looking to see if price can come back up. And again, if it does, there's highs within this area on a smaller time frame, preferably the daily, that can show us an area of liquidity. Which is just another reason for the market to come back up. Okay, so we've had a nice move to the downside throughout the whole week. Now it's time to really see the sellers run out of pressure and really get a push back to the upside before we can continue looking at how this pair is going to pan out. So we're sitting on the sidelines tomorrow to see what happens, and I'll finish off with GBP AUD. Now, again, like most pairs, you're going to find similarities in other pairs. There's going to be cross pairs that can give you a stronger indication. But, you know, when we're looking at the pound, for those that are within the UK, we had Boris Johnson speaking tonight, which isn't really going to do us any favours. He's told us to go out but stay in and don't go to work but go to work. So there's really a cluster of confusion, which is going to result to not a lot of confidence within the market. Okay. These economical factors that are happening are either going to mean two things, okay? Confidence or the opposite to confidence, okay? Weakness. If people aren't feeling confident, okay, then they're not going to buy. And if people are feeling nervous, if people are feeling more confident that the markets are looking weaker, okay, more uncertain, I should say. Yeah, uncertain and confident. You know, if the outlook is confident and positive, then we're going to have a stronger pound. If the outlook is uncertain, it's not clear, then we're going to have a very negative effect on our currency. So we're looking to see the Aussie just push back up, gain some strength at the moment over the Asian session. Throughout tomorrow, I'd like to see if the pound can rally back upwards, because if it can, I will be looking to short. If we look at the higher time frames, I mean, let's look at the monthly. Okay. The monthly shown us that price has actually come up and it's closed above this high. So we knew that this move to the downside was just a pullback. Now, the question would be, ladies and gentlemen, how far is it going to pull back? Now, we've got 18 days until this month is over. I'd like to see price come back into this green zone, okay, which is my institutional level, before I would consider price going longer. So looking at things on a smaller time frame, it hasn't really got much further to go. There's a lot of downside potential just for the simple fact that when you look at the chart from a weekly, there's a lot of buyers here since 2016. Buyers after buyers after buyers after buyers after buyers. So, you know, we shouldn't be surprised if we see price continue lower. But with that being said, we can only sit back, relax, see how the data pans out. From what we know already, price has, well, the structure has broken. Okay. So we are in a bullish structure. But at the same time, we do want to see how low price can go before buying. If I take up my Fib, I'll show you guys. We'd want price to come a lot lower, okay? Around this area. Let me mark it out for you guys. Let's give it a red area, okay? I mean, anywhere between this area here is going to give us an optimal entry, or even an entry off of our sweet zone. So, yeah, we'd like to see price come lower, but it just means before we see price come lower, we could expect to see a further pullback before, of course, the move coming lower. Monday is usually the day we get a fake move. And if that's the case, when we get a fake move on Monday, it means don't be misguided in thinking the week's going to be long just because you're getting bullish action on a Monday. With that being said, I'm going to pass over to Rodin, because I saw you're in the call. You there, bro?
Yeah, bro, thank you.
No worries.
Okay, so I will be going over AUD CAD, gold, and USD Mexican today. Yeah, so what we have seen for USD Mexican on a daily is a possible distribution setup. Although we didn't really got the price action that's needed to really confirm that this is doing distribution right now. Also, I see the DXY going higher as well after it went down a little bit. So, confluencing that to USD Mexican, I definitely see buy opportunities on this one. But when you are planning to buy this, I would advise you to put less than 1% risk on any trade you want to take. Yeah, we've got 80%. Of odds that we are continuing to the upside, and of course we've got like a little bit less than 20% chance that a reversal occurs. But for now there is a high probability that we will move out of this zone on the left and target higher prices, so at least this level. So I will be awaiting price action for a bit until we reach that level. So I've set my alarm under this low. I really want to see how USD Mexican is going to behave in this zone right here. If it gives me any indication that it is going to go up, I will place a buy and put my stop loss under the low that occurs in this range of price action.
Watch this.
Oh yeah. Okay, so I need it now. Yeah, I'm also looking at gold for this week. I've got a setup on the on I made a setup on a 1 hour because I'm looking to get a continuation for gold, especially after the downfall when the news, the NFP came out on Friday in the afternoon. So price continued to go down. We broke this level already and we broke this level. Looking from a perspective of structure and where the most liquidity is at, we will definitely be in a big odd favor if we are going to go target higher prices. From that range, I will be looking from the I will be looking around the equilibrium spot of the left down push before it went higher. And what I see right there is that this will be 50%, so this will be the exact break-even point. Also, I can notice an important level of price action. If you watch this zone on the 1 minute, you will find out that it's still left out there, and it's kind of looking like a mark for the supply and demand break-even spot, equilibrium zone. And I will be just monitoring it from now. I might take the trade like tonight, or I will be waiting for price to get here. Yeah, so there will be 27 pip stop loss, and the last TP will be 494. So that will be in 1-on-80 risk to reward ratio. If we can snag this on the 1 minute, we will have a bigger risk to reward ratio. Our first take profit will be around this zone, around this price action, and our second TP will be on this stops right here. And then we've got the last one at 14.4768. Also, I was looking at AUD CAD. So for AUD CAD, I will be looking because we closed out the high already. Like, I have to clear this up real quick. So it reacted off this continuation zone right here. This candle. Oh. Right there. And from there, we went up. We targeted this high. So that's been taken out. It's a little bit choppy the last time. So whenever it takes out liquidity, I will be searching for buy opportunities. And that will be under this level, under this level as well. We might move today and tomorrow, like under this liquidity zones, and then accumulate again to go higher. I will be targeting this high and I will holding on to it as it will continue to go higher in my opinion on the daily. And the last pair I've got was yeah, this one is still far away, so I'm gonna pass it over to Jacob right now.
Appreciate you, bro. Right, guys. Hope you guys are well. I'm gonna go over two pairs, which are Pound USD and Euro USD. We actually gave out a trade for some shorts last week, with Euro USD coming in good, but we did get stopped out on Pound USD. But the analysis was correct. It did actually give us a short opportunity, but it kind of went up a bit higher than I anticipated. But just going off of, if I take you to the dollar, it's very interesting in regards to we've had this gap filled. So price pushed down on the Friday. So we're eager to see if we get a bounce from this area or if price continues to fly by. Because if we actually look at the dollar on the daily chart, we can see that we are actually seeing some ranging in this in regards to the actual direction. It's not really gained any traction going either way. So lots of liquidity sitting below and above. So targeting an area in that regard. So if we look at the 4 hour, we can see that the gap that it had filled from the last Sunday when it opened, it actually flew up here. And now we've actually on the Friday closing, we actually came back to this area and closed. So for me, this looks like an institutional candle play. I'll be looking to see if we get a bounce when this does open, to see if we get some bullish momentum maybe when the DXY opens, or if it wants to continue down and blow past this area totally whilst taking out you know, this low and this low. And yeah, we may see some dollar weakness at the start. So it's ranging at the moment, and we would be you know, looking to see how it opens up and if we do get a reaction from here. So with that being said, if we start with Euro USD, you can see here where we called the trade out from this area here, and we actually got a push to this zone here. Now we have experienced again a rally up, which was to be anticipated from this area. Whether it's going to hold and push up further is yet to be seen. It does depend on what the DXY wants to do. For me, possibly they could have just pushed up into this selling area where they actually sold it back down to, or we have seen some accumulation from this 4-hour candle we had. In this candle here, we have seen some accumulation and a push off. In regards to targets, though, the euro for me is actually still bearish. So as you can see, it is a bit of a range similar to the DXY also. But we overall favor the bearish move down to actually create a new low, in my opinion. Whether or not it wants to try higher again, in order to come to, you know, the 109,500 area around here to play off and then fall further, will be yet to be seen. But definitely keep your eyes on that. I will be updating in Discord. We're going to see how the night plays out and what we get come pre-London session, see if we actually gain anything from this area or if it wants to continue. So with that being said, I'm going to finish off with Pound USD. So similar thing, like we got a push off of an area last week. Didn't actually, when we was calling the sell, we was actually looking for this low to get taken out. It didn't actually take out that low, and then we rallied up higher. So a lot of downside targets still actually intact, whether or not they want to go for it or if they want to just continue higher, because we do have this equal high that has been left as well. Overall, we are still bearish on the 4-hour chart. And the daily chart is bearish also. I mean, excuse me, bullish on 4-hour and bullish on the daily. We are wanting to push higher. We can see prices wanting to push higher in order to complete, in my opinion, what would be a lower high on the weekly. We are yet to actually complete that. So with this target being said, maybe we get a push higher into our weekly sell zone, and then we can get a nice swing trade from this area above. So we are wanting to be buyers up until that point, because it is like some 400 pips away. So definitely trying to capitalize on that. So for sure, we will be definitely updating the Discord with this area also. So a lot of liquidity being pushed into the downside, as I was saying earlier, given retail traders' hope of, you know, support, so to speak. Random support area, so to speak, and at some stage we should see, you know, what some of these targets taken out. So definitely just depends on whether we get that bullish momentum coming in from the DXY in order to execute the further downside movement. So we do have a massive imbalance gap also. So whether they want to just hold this area and continue, it's yet to be seen. So we are in a bit of a range here, but overall we are bullish on the 4-hour and daily. So bear in mind, you know, it is the start of the week. We need to see. We're not in no rush to get in any trades tonight. We'd like to see how the morning unveils and see if we can see some price action that we're familiar with. So be patient with the setups, guys, with the Euro US and the Pound US, because they will tell us what they want to do eventually. So that's pretty much it. Like I said, stay in tune with the Discord. You know, we'll be sure to post as well. And please, please, guys, if you haven't already, like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, man. All the support is appreciated. We appreciate everyone of you that has already subscribed. And remember,
every day is money day. Peace.